8 competitors are going to compete for the right to take on middleweight champion Evil Weevil. Welcome to the Junkyard Joust Head On. I'm Aaron Yanda, and here are your 8 competitors, all chomping at the bit, some of them literally, to take on Evil Weevil. Cars are going to get a point for knocking another car off the track, a point for knocking it upside down, and of course a point for knocking it out of bounds. That's a total of 3 points from a hit, plus you can get an additional point for doing damage to your opponent. That's obvious damage, not just paint flakes. And you automatically win your match if the other car is unable to compete any longer. First up, it's Hotwiler, sponsored by Mr. Stratholm, and Hitchhike Mike, the Garbage Pail Kid, sponsored by Hey Hey's Hatchback Hanger. Both of these vehicles weigh 36 grams, pretty evenly matched here. Let's see what happens. And a big hit there, and Hitchhike Mike is coming out on top. Just punished Hotwiler, knocking him flying off the track over and over again, and then casually finishing his stroll down the track. And Hotwiler's upside down over in the corner. It's gonna be 3 points for Hitchhike Mike. Off to a bad start for Hotwiler, and Hitchhike Mike's gotta be happy with how that went. No significant damage to either of these vehicles as we head into the second hit. This time, Hitchhike Mike will be coming down from the left and Hotwiler from the right. Here we go, round 2. Ooh, a savage hit there from Hotwiler. He rocks Hitchhike Mike. Tossed him back up the track and ripped off the top of that Jeep. Take a look at this impact. Hotwiler just obliterating Hitchhike Mike. And then both cars slowly slide back down the track. Now, neither of them is going to be out of bounds because they are still on the track. And as long as they're on the track, they're not out of bounds. So Hotwiler's going to pick up a point for knocking Hitchhike Mike sideways. And I think the damage check's gonna be pretty obvious in this situation. They're going again, round 3. That Jeep with no top this time, so no worry about that coming off. And it's a massive hit. Hotwiler gets the advantage again, knocking Hitchhike Mike all the way out of bounds, just the edge. Tough to tell for sure if he's out of bounds here. We'll have to check Skycam for that. Somehow Mike makes a recovery and lands it right side up after a lot of tumbling around. Little lucky move off of that hay bale. Hotwiler not giving up a single point this round. You can see his jaws moving up and down as he goes back and forth on the track. Taking a look at Skycam, it's the moment of truth here for Mike, and Mike was out of bounds. And look at this. Because of the way Mike spun off those hay bales, he's not out of bounds. The line says it all. That means even after that huge hit, Hotwiler is just going to tie the score, and we are going to have to go for a round 4 tiebreaker. Here we go. Bam! Another big hit from Hotwiler, and Hitchhike Mike goes tumbling off the track out of bounds. Both vehicles taking a nasty backwards bounce, but Hotwiler manages to at least stay on the track. Hitchhike Mike did manage to make a recovery, but he's still gonna give Hotwiler 2 points, 1 for being out of bounds and 1 for getting knocked off the track. Mike picks up a point for knocking Hotwiler sideways, but that's not enough. It's 5-4. Hotwiler is gonna move on in this middleweight competition. Next up, you love to hate him, it's Jar Jar Binks, sponsored by Swedenborg Smorgasbord, and Dozer, sponsored by Sid from Cybertron. Dozer's got a 5-gram weight advantage. Here we go, round 1. And a nice hit there. Both cars managed to stay in bounds. Look at all the stuff flying off of the vehicles. I think that was all off the front of Jar Jar Binks. Look at that, just shredding the front of Jar Jar Binks is Dozer. Pieces of paint flying everywhere. Oh man, I can't wait to go into the damage and see what happened there. In the meantime, it looks like Dozer's gonna get 2 points, 1 for knocking Jar Jar off and 1 for knocking him sideways. And Jar Jar's gonna pick up a point for knocking Dozer sideways. Looks like Jar Jar lost a lot of paint off the front of his car, but no other damage than paint flanks, so no points for Dozer there. Dozer basically unharmed in this situation because of his massive front shovel. Here we go again, round 2. And another big hit there. Jar Jar knocked off the track again. Similar results as last time. Even more paint flakes flying off of Jar Jar Binks. Dozer just having his way with Jar Jar. And that is going to be another round of 2 points for Dozer. 1 for Jar Jar makes the score 4-2. I don't think Jar Jar's got a lot of paint to lose up front in round 3, but I guess we'll see what happens. Here they come. And another nice hit there. Dozer managing to knock Jar Jar out of bounds this time, but Jar Jar making a recovery. It's not going to make any difference. Dozer's got enough points to win this round. More pieces flying everywhere. Just serious damage going on almost entirely to Jar Jar Binks. Jar Jar gets pushed out of bounds and off the track, gives 2 points to Dozer. Quick damage check. Yeah, it appears Jar Jar sustained even more paint loss, but no other major loss, so no points for damage. And Dozer still looks solid. Jar Jar gets 2 this time. Gonna go up to 4, but Dozer goes up to 6 and takes the victory. Dozer's gonna move on, but right now we're gonna find out who Hotwiler will face in the semifinals. It's gonna be one of these two, Rigor Motors at 37 grams or Warp Speeder at 30 grams. Rigor Motors sponsored by Raygull Radio and Warp Speeder sponsored by Judy Collins. Here we go. Ooh, wow, Rigor Motors pops Warp Speeder up into the sky. He got some serious height on that hit, and Rigor Motors does not get knocked off the track. It sits there spinning. There goes Warp Speeder all the way up to 12.2 meters beyond our ability to actually measure, but you know, we can estimate. And Warp Speeder cannot land it. Lands upside down and gives up 2 points to Rigor Motors on this first run. That was savage. Let's do a damage check. Rigor Motors has some trouble with those front tires, but I think they were already like that. And Warp Speeder, pretty solid. Big hit there, but Warp Speeder does not lose anything off his vehicle. Here we go, second round. This time they'll be coming down from opposite sides. And a solid impact there sends Rigor Motors off the track and Warp Speeder back up the track. And that is actually going to give Warp Speeder a couple of points. Rigor Motors turning sideways and not able to right himself. Warp Speeder manages to stay on the track and only give Rigor Motors 1 more point. So that's going to bring the score up to 3-2. And we've got a very close match right now. Usually when the first car gets 3 points to start out with, you expect that they're going to do well, but it didn't happen with Hitchhike Mike. And the third hit is another doozy. Warp Speeder knocking Rigor Motors upside down and managing to stay on the track. And that's going to give Warp Speeder 1 point. And that is going to make this a tie match right now. So what would normally have been the final round, we're going to have to go on to the fourth round tiebreaker. See if we can break this tie between these two cars. This has been a heated match so far. So here we go on round number 4. Warp Speeder will be coming on your left, Rigor on your right. And a big hit there. Rigor seems to get the best of it, but Warp Speeder stays on the track. Rigor Motors managed to knock Warp Speeder all the way back, but then got knocked completely off the track, especially on that second run by Warp Speeder, just making sure he was off the track there. And that is going to give Warp Speeder the winning point. Rigor Motors' bid for the middleweight championship is going to end right here. Unless there was some sort of damage, I'm not hearing any reports of damage, so it does look like this is Warp Speeder's match. 4-3 in a squeaker. Congrats to Warp Speeder. They're going to move on to face Hotwiler in the semifinal, which is going to happen right after this next match between these two. Hoverstorm, 31 grams, sponsored by Wolf of Fiber Art, and Lean Machine, 39 grams, sponsored by Stumps Tree Farm. This should be interesting. We got one with the big bumper and one with the pointed snout. Here we go with the first joust. Whoa! Lean Machine is gone! Lean Machine has gone apparently over into a neighboring farmer's field. We are unable to get any video footage of that, unfortunately. We don't actually have clearance to shoot on his land. So, unfortunately, you're not going to be able to see what happened to Lean Machine. 11.5 on the height meter on his way over to that other patch of land over there. And we're hearing that Lean Machine is indeed right side up over there. So, Hoverstorm's going to get 2 points, although we are going to take a look at the damage, and we're going to try to get Lean Machine back off of his property over there. Hoverstorm holding up pretty well with that big cushy bumper in the front, and Lean Machine, a little bit of paint maybe, probably got some mud on the bottom of his vehicle from landing in that field, but it looks like we're ready for another hit. And it's a good one. The weight advantage is with Lean Machine, but Lean Machine is the one getting knocked backwards out of bounds by Hoverstorm. Not what you might expect to happen in this exchange. Lean Machine just flipping all over the place, takes out a hay bale on his way out, and he is definitely sideways on this one, so that's gonna be a full trifecta. 3 points for Hoverstorm, and Lean Machine's gonna get 1 for knocking Hoverstorm off the track. That's gonna take the score up to 5-1. won, there is still a chance Lean Machine could bring it back, but he would have to do damage to Hoverstorm and get him completely knocked out of bounds upside down. Here we go. And again, Lean Machine goes flying all over the place and lands upside down. The point in front of that vehicle, which they probably thought was gonna work as a weapon to take cars out, not working in Lean Machine's favor. And this is a definitive domination by Hoverstorm. Just a great hit there, knocking Lean Machine upside down. Hoverstorm not going out of bounds, giving Lean Machine 1 point. You're gonna end this matchup with 7-2, a high scoring match for Hoverstorm. Hoverstorm is gonna move on to face Dozer in the semifinal, and that is happening now. After that, Hotwiler is gonna take on Warp Speeder. The winners of these two matches will have the title fight, and the winner of that will fight Evil Weevil for the middleweight championship. Up first, it's gonna be Dozer versus Hoverstorm. Dozer has a 9-gram weight advantage in this situation, but that didn't bother Hoverstorm in the last match. Let's see what happens. The first hit is a big one. Car's going back and forward. Dozer goes sideways, flips right over. Hoverstorm is solid and does not go off the track and stays nice and centered. A great hit right there. So much movement backwards. Dozer really giving it to Hoverstorm, but Hoverstorm holding so steady. And we're gonna have to do a damage check, but it looks like Dozer is just gonna be the only one giving up a point this time to Hoverstorm. Assuming there's no damage. Oh, actually I see something on the track there, but I can't tell if that's pieces of the track or pieces of Hoverstorm. Well, let's go to damage. Big surprise, Dozer looks fine. Maybe a couple chunks of paint lost on the front of that shovel. Hoverstorm has sustained some damage, but I don't see any pieces broken off. It kind of looks like Dozer might have just pushed the pieces back inside the actual chassis of Hoverstorm. Here we go on round two. And another nice hit. This time, Hoverstorm gets the worst of it, getting pushed out of bounds, making a nice recovery though. And Dozer gets pushed off the track, but also makes a recovery. So not a bad round for either of these vehicles, and that is gonna make this a tie match. Dozer's gonna pick up 2 for the out of bounds and off the track, and Hoverstorm's gonna get a point for knocking Dozer off the track. And I don't see any chunks flying off either of those vehicles, so that means there's no damage points. We do indeed have a tie match right here. This third round could decide it all. Here they come. And Hoverstorm and Dozer meet in the middle of the track and nobody budges. Not a single point's gonna go out this turn. That was just a big hit. And unless there was some damage to somebody, I don't think anybody's getting points. I don't see anything there that looks like anything came off of the vehicle. So it looks like we are going into another round. Fourth round tiebreaker, very popular in this particular middleweight division event. Neither of these cars wanting to give an inch. Here we go on the fourth smash. Impact at the center, and this time Dozer gets the best of it. Hoverstorm getting knocked out of bounds, but look at this. Hoverstorm may be out of bounds, but Hoverstorm is also right side up, and Dozer is upside down and off the track. That means that they're both gonna get 2 points. 2 points and 2 points equals 4-4. This thing is still tied. We have to go again. Someone has to win this fight. Here comes the fifth round, another tiebreaker. And this time, Hoverstorm gets Dozer off the rails, upside down, out of bounds. The full 3 points. This is Dozer's last stand. Hoverstorm has taken this match. Look at that hit. Wow, Hoverstorm just goes flying backwards, but got enough of a punch in on Dozer to cause the damage necessary to put Dozer down. Dozer off the track and officially out of bounds. You can tell by the red line. And Hoverstorm, your winner, going on to the final. 7-5, the final score in this semifinal match. The battle for the right to fight Evil Weevil for the middleweight championship continues as Hoverstorm moves on and is gonna face one of these two in the final. Hotwiler versus Warp Speeder. Hotwiler has a slight weight advantage. That weight didn't bother Warp Speeder last time. Here we go in our first round. And a solid hit from Warp Speeder there. Hotwiler goes flying off the track and underneath the track, right side up. So saved himself a point there. But Warp Speeder stays on the track and is going to pick up two for a great hit. Stuck up on the track, but nailed it really nicely. And there's that shot from above. Hotwiler taking off, kind of hiding, actually. That dog's going to have to learn how to bite if it wants to get some points here against Warp Speeder. Damage check. Warp Speeder looking good. A couple of nicks here and there, but nothing major. Hotwiler also looking good. That jawline holding up nicely. No lost teeth on that one. Round two coming up now. Hotwiler on the right. Hotwiler gets slammed again off, similar to last time, but this time he doesn't go under the track. He lands it right side up, but Warp Speeder refuses to budge. It just stays on the track, nice and smooth this time. And Hotwiler is gonna lose another 2 points. He is gonna need a miracle to come out of this one with a win. Only thing he can do right now, actually, is tie this match. He'd have to break something off of Warp Speeder and get the full 3 points. I don't see it happening. Ooh, from that top view, you can really see Hotwiler and how the force of it just knocks him spinning off the track. We're gonna do a quick damage check just to make sure that there isn't any missing parts here. Warp Speeder looking solid. Maybe another scuff right on the top there. And Hotwiler tried to take a bite out of Warp Speeder. Didn't happen this time, but Hotwiler still looks good as well. Here we go. This is it. Round three. Hotwiler's got to do something here. And Hotwiler doesn't do anything except knock Warp Speeder upside down. But that's not going to be enough. Hotwiler good at staying upright, but that is about it. You'd think that Hotwiler with that weight advantage wouldn't be so easy to knock backwards, but Warp Speeder's just got something going on there. Some indefinable quality, maybe just a little extra mojo, who knows? It wasn't a complete shutout. Hotwiler managed to get that 1 point in the final hit, but Warp Speeder 6-1. Dominating Hotwiler in this match. And we are moving on to the final. The winner of this match will face Evil Weevil for the middleweight championship belt. Warp Speeder, 30 grams. Hoverstorm, 31 grams. This is it. What a fight. Get ready for this. Here we go, round one. And a nice hit there by Warp Speeder, but Hoverstorm recovers, and Warp Speeder's forced off the track. Did Hoverstorm flip around and land? I can't believe my eyes right now. Wow, I have absolutely no idea how Hoverstorm managed to do a 360 and stay on the track. You barely even could see it. If not for the slow-mo cam, we wouldn't have even known that that happened, probably. You just assume that he bounced back. That was insane. And Warp Speeder's gonna lose 2 points now. Hoverstorm gaining from the out-of-bounds and the knock off the track. Taking a look at damage, Hoverstorm is definitely looking a little worse for wear at the moment, but no parts are coming off. Seems like they're just getting pushed back inside. Warp Speeder still looking great. Just an extra scuff now. 2-0. Here comes the second hit. And it's a doozy this time. Warp Speeder getting the upper hand. Hoverstorm cannot pull off another 360 and goes flying way out of bounds. Speeder got the edge on him and knocks him back up the track and right off, and then manages to stay on the track this time. And that is going to make this an interesting match because now it's a tie 2-0. Hoverstorm over off the side there. Good recovery, and that prevents Warp Speeder from getting the upper hand here. Looks like there's no obvious damage here, so we're gonna go straight into round three, and it's a nice one, and this time Hoverstorm goes back off the track. Again, cannot make that amazing 360. It may have just been a bit of luck there at the beginning of the match, and Warp Speeder shows dominance here with that hit. Hoverstorm knocked for a loop out of bounds, flies all the way up the track, can't stay on. Lands right side up again, which is great, but not enough to win this match. Warp Speeder is going to get 2 points and go 4-2. We'll do a final damage check just for the fun of it. Hoverstorm is really looking beat up now. Honestly, not sure the front of that car would have survived a hit from Evil Weevil, so maybe it's a blessing in disguise here. Warp Speeder moving on to the final. No damage there. 4-2, your official score in this final match. Middleweight championship fight is coming up in just a sec, but first, we're going to see who gets third place. One run down the track. The results are final. One of these cars is going to get third place. Hotwiler or Dozer will claim it. Here we go. Let's see who gets it. And a nice hit there. Dozer pushed out of bounds, and Hotwiler manages to stay on the track. And they're both upside down. Hotwiler's going to get 3 points for this. And Dozer is only going to get the one for knocking Hotwiler upside down. Great hit by Hotwiler. There could be damage here. It might be worth checking, even though it's not going to make any difference with the score. One more look from the overhead view. And yeah, you can see that nice hit. Dozer just cannot stay on this track. Might be just a bit top heavy. And in terms of damage, of course, Dozer is looking fine, and Hotwiler also looking good. That front bumper is pretty durable on that thing. Congrats to Hotwiler getting third place tonight, 3-1 against Dozer. And now it's the fight you've all been waiting for, the middleweight division championship title match. Wow, that's a mouthful. Evil Weevil won last time, and now it's gonna face Warp Speeder. 7 gram weight difference here. Will it make any difference? Let's find out. Here comes hit number one. And the first hit ends with both cars seem to be locked together. That wasn't a hit so much as a connection. Weevil and the Speeder seem to have formed a bond here. I hope it's not permanent. We're gonna have to see if we can pry these two cars apart and see if there's any damage there. But as it stands right now, no points are gonna be given because Weevil actually stopped Warp Speeder from going off the track by getting stuck in the front of the car. Taking a closer look at what's going on here, yeah, Weevil's mandibles just got stuck in the front grill of Warp Speeder. I don't see any pieces missing. Some pretty good damage there, though. And of course, Evil Weevil, not a scratch. Incredible. Here we go. It's hit number two. What's gonna happen this time? And the same thing happens. It's unbelievable. They switch sides and still they lock together. Those mandibles going up inside Warp Speeder, and Warp Speeder cannot escape. But they're both still on the track, and nobody's gonna get points for this. Something has gotta happen to cause these two to not lock together. This is something I never expected to happen. This is supposed to be a joust, guys, not some sort of melding. Let's try it again. And there we go, some action finally. They didn't lock together, but Evil Weevil not able to get Warp Speeder off the track. It's a little bit underneath him, but Warp Speeder manages to plant himself on that track and hold on for dear life a little bit farther, and he could have tipped and fallen off, but he's gonna be safe there. That is not out of bounds. If you're on the track, you're in bounds. Seems like maybe things are loosening up here a little bit though. Let's run it again, opposite sides. And this time, Evil Weevil almost knocks Warp Speeder off again, but Warp Speeder won't have it. Warp Speeder gets tossed up the track and hangs on yet again, but it feels like it's only a matter of time before Evil Weevil has his way with Warp Speeder. Warp Speeder's got to do something here to try to prevent Evil Weevil from manhandling him like that, or insect handling, I guess it would be. We're gonna take a look at the damage again. If there's any serious damage, any pieces missing, it doesn't look like there is on Warp Speeder. A lot of damage up front, but nothing came off. And of course, Evil Weevil still looking good. If either of these cars loses a piece of their vehicle, it could give the other guy victory. Warp Speeder might be his only chance. Maybe he can knock off one of those mandibles. And another lock in the center of the track. They've connected again and refused to go anywhere. Evil Weevil grabbing, or maybe Warp Speeder just holding on for dear life here, but they are almost off the edge. If they had flipped over, could have made a difference, or maybe it would have just given them both the same amount of points. We've got to have a situation happen here where one of these cars gets points. Let's do it again. And again, they land right on the edge, teeter, and almost fall over. What an epic middleweight championship battle. Neither of these two want to give up. Nobody's even gotten a point. We have to go until someone gets a point. One of these cars has to be crowned the new middleweight championship. We're gonna keep doing it until something happens. We might be here all night, folks, but by the end of this, I promise you, we'll have a winner. And finally, Evil Weevil knocks Warp Speeder for a loop off the edge, off the track, out of bounds, upside down. that is it. Evil Weevil actually almost gets knocked off the track. You don't see that very often. That was a mighty hit right there. Good effort by Warp Speeder. He stuck it out as long as he could, but Evil Weevil remains victorious, remains middleweight champion, 3-0 in this Junkyard Joust head on. Your two-time middleweight division champion, Evil Weevil. They fought tooth and mandible to get to this point, but your middleweight champion remains Evil Weevil. Congrats to the Weevil for that. Your track buffer, pretty good at the Junkyard Joust, everybody. Hope you enjoyed this episode. We'll have another heavyweight match coming up for you in the coming weeks. It's going to be Silver Bullet taking on a new champion. Leave a like or a comment. Helps with the algorithm. Can get some more views on the Junkyard Joust series. Thanks for watching, everybody. Consider becoming a patron at patreon.com/junkyardjoust and help me keep making this show. Thank you so much to all of you who are patrons. And thank you to Jesse, AJ, and Tony, who are the crew of this show and are the reason I'm able to bring it to you as much as I do. And we'll see you next time on the Joust.